John, would you like to say a little, don't mean to take you by surprise,
no,
but
no, that's okay.
you're on camera.
G'day, how you going? Second time out, we've got the card table now. We've got plenty of material. Not that much interest today so far, but there's been a few people that have taken a few DVDs away. So what can I say? It's another month and moving towards September 11. Hopefully we can build this awareness in Australia, the land of Murdoch, as I like to call it. We're probably at the ends of the earth as far as the info war goes, just like we are in a lot of other ways.
Lack of freedom is what a lot of the American model is based on, but they can't come out and say it. You know, that's what's going to happen. You look at China, and then you look at what's going to happen in the rest of the world. 9/11 truth to me is looking at the evidence that clearly shows that the official story that the two planes brought down the towers is a complete fabrication.
What's your perspective on this this phrase 911 truth? What does that mean for you?
For me, it means it's a weak excuse.
Three DVDs. Here you go, man. John, David. Nice to meet you.
How you going?
Yeah, John, do you want to just give a recap as to what we have here, the materials that we're giving out today?
Yeah, okay, we've got Improbable Collapse. Okay, which is quite a good film.
Yep.
We've got American Freedom to Fascism. It's obviously an Alex Jones. We've got Terror Storm, another Alex Jones production. We've got something that Carol sent me.
Can you just hold that up?
Behind Every Terrorist is a Bush.
Zoom in on that for a second. Okay, that's interesting, yep.
Okay, we've got a combination. As we know, Sophia wasn't very happy about us giving away free copies of 911 Mysteries, but I already
Absolutely.
Had some that were burnt that were a Google download, which is a low-quality version.
Yep.
I've got that in a compilation with Terror Storm, so I hope she's not too upset about that, but we're planning on buying a lot of directly from her. So hopefully that'll be cool. Anyway,
Can you hold up that one over there? That book, I bought that last week. That's currently on sale at the bookstore just down the road here.
Oh, really? Oh, okay.
Kino Quinia, you know that one?
I couldn't find any non-material at my local bookstore.
It's unusual, that's why I snapped it up. But if anyone wants to go and buy it, they can buy it from, actually, can you point down that way?
Okay.
It's down there, right? Just down there. There's a huge bookstore, it's called Kino Quinia, and they've got that book.
Oh, okay, excellent.
So Dan, as an engineer, can you explain to me how buildings can crumble to the ground at the speed of freefall while being pulverized into powder and generating a giant pyroclastic flow? Can you explain to me what sort of technology, other than sort of airplanes and jet fuel, might be needed to produce such an incredible
it's the power of bullshit.
Pyrotechnical event?
Is that Hollywood? The power of Hollywood.
Now you're not a no-planer, I hope.
No.
We don't tolerate no-planers around here.
Well, I mean, it's just, I mean, you can argue about the technical details till the cows come home. Obviously it was set up. I mean, but no one will ever know, really, because it's like, be like JFK. I mean, there's so much misinformation put out there as well as real information. I mean,
yeah, it's all mixed up, isn't it?
The fact is, you know, there's no reason to go to war.
Yeah.
And there's no reason to kill people, and there's no reason to spend money on defence when you could spend it on health and education.
Yeah, look, I didn't start out being this kind of person. And it took a long time for me to be persuaded that the official narrative of 911 was completely false. I knew that parts of it were totally wrong. We've got some material here, some videos, some books, etc. It took quite some time for me to be fully convinced that the entire 911 story was fake. I was quite skeptical about some of the things about it from the beginning. I didn't immediately question whether the World Trade Center was demolished, because I just don't know enough about engineering, etc. I was very skeptical about the plane hijacking story. It seemed implausible. I was very skeptical when I discovered that the transponders had all been switched off on the planes. That didn't make any sense.
Straight down. See the crink? See here the crink in the middle?
Yeah, I reckon.
Right? See it? Yeah. That happens when they blow the center columns.
Yeah.
And you get the crink.
Oh, okay, yeah.
The crink, so that when it falls in with.
Like when they knock down the casino.
Yeah, exactly. So, you know, that alone is proof in the pudding that and also BBC on the day broadcast that Building 7 had collapsed 20 minutes before it actually had collapsed. So you got the prisoner going, yes, here we are in New York and the World Trade, the Solomon Building has collapsed, and she turns for a second and then the building is still standing. So the question, how do they know that it's going to collapse? Obviously there was something, obviously was an organizer in the organization, but she was teleprompted to say it. How did the BBC hear that it was going to collapse?
So why are you so fired up about this idea?
Well, good question. I think one of the main reasons is all the changes in the laws that have happened. Have you gone to the airport lately? You seem like you've travelled.
Yes.
Yeah, you have to take your shoes off, empty liquid bottles of water into the bin, throw them away. You know, there's all these new ASIO laws. If ASIO arrests you and you don't answer their questions, you go to jail. You don't have the right not to answer questions anymore. So you go to jail just for not answering a question. I mean, and it's called the tyrannical shuffle. Step here. No one notices it. Absolutely. 1933, I think it was, the Reichstag fire. You know about the Reichstag fire?
It's not ever. But I'm trying to get my text.
You know, do you know about the project for a new American century? Okay, an organization made up of neocons. You know who the neocons are?
Neoconservatives.
Yeah, neoconservatives. There was a guy called Leo Strauss, and he has some very particular theories about society and all these kind of things. And anyway, all these students of Leo Strauss are now in the White House. They formed a group called the Project for a New American
Century. Well, Wolfowitz was in it.
Rumsfeld
was in it.
Cheney may have been part of it.
Yeah, definitely Wolfowitz, definitely Rumsfeld.
And Jeb Bush.
Shooter Libby.
Yes.
He was in it.
Prominent neoconservatives, and they released a document in September 2000 that said, called Rebuilding America's Defenses, and pretty much, if I could summarize the extensive document, they pretty much said that we need to increase spending, we need to have a basis, permanent basis in the Middle East, we need to secure resources in the Middle East, and all this stuff, and you know, all these types of things won't happen until we have a new Pearl Harbor. Until we have a new Pearl Harbor.
Six people that said they're actually interested in getting involved in activism, which was good. We had actually standing protesters. We had probably a little bit more than double, probably around 10 for most of the time we were here.
Yeah.
So I'm happy with that. We were aiming for 8.
And a lot of people just came along and grabbed stuff.
Yeah.
A lot of people just grabbed stuff and walked on, but they were interested, you know what I mean?
Yeah, we had a sociologist teacher at University of New South Wales or Sydney. Yeah, but anyway, she's going to distribute a lot of material.
Yeah.
She's going to do a lecture on critical thought and look at all the material and get the class to analyse it.
Yeah, yeah.
Which is very cool.
Very good.
Yeah, no, we had... Yeah.
I think it was incredibly successful.
Yeah, very, very successful. Yeah. I don't know about incredible.
We'll leave that for...
Just like exponential.
We'll
allow that.
Yeah,
exponential. But, yeah, it's a
We'll reserve that word for next time.
Straight line rise.
Yeah, okay.